Stop trying to fit in. Stop. That's boring. If it's killing you, just stop. It's not your small titties or your small booty that's the problem. It's your insecurities, okay? It's how you're feeling about yourself. It's your mindset. Just find what you like to do. Stop trying to follow everybody else. Stop trying to fit in. That's so boring. That's so lame. It'll only lead to you being miserable in the end. It is hot as balls today. Even though I have the AC running and I have the fan running. I mean, really, how much more can I run before I run from Florida? You know what I'm saying? It's me, I'm back. It's been a couple of weeks, probably months at this point. My mega problem over the past couple of months, not including not having the motivation to make videos, but Final Cut has had a bug since the past three updates, since like 10.65, I don't know the numbers, whatever, three updates ago, I've been having issues. Okay, I can't export my video. I have had a masterpiece just sitting, waiting to come out, and Apple has refused to fix the fucking bug. So it's been very demotivating because I already know how to use it. I am very good at it. Wow. Well, some of you might say I'm shit, but okay, I'm decent at it. Okay, I can say I'm at least decent at it. But yes, Final Cut Pro. That's a problem. And until that gets resolved, I will either be editing on an older version or pulling my hair out, trying to learn a new program all over again. And it's okay. I can add it to my resume, because fuck college. That's another story. Maybe not the best introduction to how to love yourself in a world full of miserable, lonely people. But hi, welcome back to my channel. Or welcome if you are new. This is Closeted Thoughts. So far, my only show I can keep consistent on my channel, where we talk about controversial topics and things that might make you uncomfortable. Opinions you might not like. Opinions that, I don't know, I don't really care. Opinions that you might not care about. Who knows? I don't know why you're here. I don't know why I'm here. Thanks, Mom and Dad. Yes, in a world full of lonely people. How does one love themselves? I don't know how long I'm gonna be talking about this topic. Fuck scripts, okay? Scripts are boring. I don't want to adhere to a script, okay? I want to get it off of my goddamn chest. Off of my chest. You're going to hear it straight from the heart here on Closeted Thoughts, okay? I guess they're called Closeted Thoughts for a reason. My mother called me one day and she was like, hey Maya, I know you've been like doing really good with your channel recently, but like maybe you should cover up your closet. And I was like, nah, Mom, they like that. I don't know. I don't care if you like it or not. It's my background. This is the most soundproof room in my cheap ass, or should I say my overvalued apartment that they decided to raise my rent on. This old junk of an apartment, okay? This is the most soundproof room. You can hear everything else everywhere else. In fact, you can still hear things in here, so it doesn't really matter. Which I'm just realizing. But you know, it's part of the theme, okay? Closeted thoughts in the fucking closet. I mean, it doesn't get any more relevant than that, right? I'ma stop talking. Let me put on this light. Wow. Anyways, how to love yourself in a world full of people who are lonely. Or maybe you're lonely. Of course you're here because you're lonely. Maybe this is why we need a script. Anyways, look at me. I am a regular Joe Schmo. Jane Schmo, whatever you want to call it. Did I dress up for this? My face, yes. I did my face. Because black was resonating with me today. Black has been resonating with me on most of the days. I don't want to be here. I don't want to be here. It's reflecting my soul. My soul has blackened. Some people say there's a connection between the body and the soul and that there's both. But we haven't been able to prove the existence of a soul. If that soul does exist, I'm hoping that soul is tired. Because I am tired. I don't want to come back down here again. So fuck you, reincarnation. Fuck you. Honestly, I don't even know why I have my laptop out. We might not even be talking about anything on Reddit today. I, for one, need to get off of Reddit. So step one, delete your social media. Social media is a great place for you to see how other people are doing well, because they don't post the worst parts of their life. If you want to feel horrible about yourself, step one is to go onto social media. To not feel horrible about yourself is to get rid of the social media. Honestly, I haven't been missing it. Now, I don't really care what you post on your story. I don't. Quite frankly, I don't. I don't care what's going on in your life. So I stopped using Instagram for the past couple of months. Well, if you can't delete your social media, go through your pages. Everything needs decluttering, okay? This is my problem with life. Everything requires maintenance and work. Literally everything. Go through all of that and make sure that you get rid of those pages that make you feel like shit. It's really that simple. Do you follow some plastic looking who has the body that you want, but you'll never be able to have? Why are you following them? Why are you following them to make yourself feel like shit? There's no point. If you are a black person following a white person, and you want to look like the white person, you see where I'm coming from with this? Follow some gals, who have natural hair. I'm sorry, like, this deodorant is literally melting. It's fucking melting. I didn't apply that much, okay? It's like melting because it's hot. There's nothing I can do about it. I either stink or I look like this. I'm sorry. I'm posting this shit on the internet, so you'd think that I would know what confidence is about, right? Yes. I'm here to tell you how to be unbothered. Either delete your social fucking media, or fix it. Curate it to where you're not feeling like shit about yourself. Follow pages that post positive things. Follow people that look like you. And follow people who post more body positivity focused content. Nobody really needs a social media account. The world was going long before it was even a thing. It will continue to go without social media. Can it enhance your lives? Perhaps. Can it make you feel less lonely? Perhaps. I appreciate Reddit because it has so many subreddits that have a lot of topics that I'm interested in. For pages like Instagram and Snapchat. I low-key feel like Snapchat is like the most useless of them all. I don't care for Snapchat so much that I haven't even like downloaded the app just to delete my account. Like, it's already dead to me. I will never use Snapchat again. Pointless fucking app to me. But yeah, I'm just like, why do I need to see pictures from other people's lives? Just follow what's important to you. Get rid of all these pages making you feel terrible. All these fucking fitness pages that make you feel like shit because you're not exercising every day for 2 hours every fucking week. Follow pages that are realistic. And if you can't do that, get rid of it. Or even if you can do it, you're probably better off without it. And sometimes I should take my own advice, because it's not like Reddit is the best of them all. I do find that I learn a lot more from Reddit than I do from the rest of these social media applications. YouTube is social media, yes, you are here watching me. This is a social media platform, but it's different. And yes, you can learn anything anywhere. But I'm just like, certain apps, like Snapchat, what the fuck for? I don't care what's going on in your lives. I don't really care what you did today. I don't care what you ate today. Nobody cares. That's why I stopped posting. I don't even care about my own posts, to be honest. What's the point? What am I trying to prove to people? I have nothing to prove. I'm pretty happy with myself. Pretty fucking honest with my... why do I keep doing that? I am pretty honest with myself. I have nothing to prove to anybody. The only person I need to prove anything to is myself. Yes, we're rambling. Yes, I shat on scripts, but it's from the heart. Closeted thoughts will always be from the heart. So yes, step one, get rid of your freaking social media. You don't need that shit. Number two, come to realize that it's okay to like yourself. There's nothing wrong with liking how you were born. Nothing wrong in taking comfort in that this body, this vessel, is how you are going to be for a long, long time. Can you modify this vessel? Yes. Should you? Questionable. I understand if you are having health problems from how you were born. Should that be modified? Yes. If you are in pain from how you were born? Yes. Please feel free to go and get surgery and get that fixed. Get your pain fixed. But you know, if you were born with something that's not affecting your life, aka small titties, aka flat ass, okay, something I don't have, but it doesn't matter. It's okay. It's really okay. Hang out with people who don't make you feel like shit. It's as simple as that. Curate your friend group, your family. We don't get to choose our family, but you sure as hell don't have to validate their thoughts. And you sure as hell don't have to spend time with that family if they're a piece of shit. Find people, good people. Find good people that will help you feel good about yourself. They're out there. They are out there for sure. You just gotta look for them. Sometimes it feels like the world is mostly shitty people, but there are good people. And most of those good people are out being good people, not on social media attacking you and making you feel like shit. Good people are out there doing good. They exist. Go find them. Fuck the haters and the naysayers. You are fine just the way you are, unless of course it's affecting your health. I feel like that's the only reason why you should be worried about something per se. If your health is being affected by it, then go change it. Mental health is a different story. Yes, you know, maybe you would feel better if you had a boob job. Maybe you would feel better about yourself if you had a BBL. But at the end of the day, it's not your small titties or your small booty that's the problem. It's your insecurities, okay? It's how you're feeling about yourself. It's your mindset. There's nothing wrong with you, okay? The sooner you realize that, the better. The sooner you realize that you can like yourself for you, you'll stop trying to reach these milestones and these goals. You'll stop trying to be like everybody else. Find your own path. And that's step number three. Step number three to loving yourself, or to becoming more confident in yourself, whatever you want to call it. It's a journey, okay? It's not as simple as just following these steps. It's a journey. It's being okay with yourself, even when you might not be the ideal body type. Being okay with yourself when you're not very popular. Being okay with yourself when other people might not like you. There are billions of people on this planet. People keep throwing out more fucking kids. I don't know why. Can already barely afford to take care of everybody else here, because yes, we have slavery, we have poverty, we have starving people, we have homelessness. I don't know why people are having more kids, but just realize that it's okay to be you. I know my opinions are very fucking unpopular, but here I am. I don't care if people come and shit on my videos. Do so, please. That's good for my engagement. Come to my comments and hate on me. Do it. I don't care. I don't care if you shit on this outfit that I'm wearing, because it's not even an outfit to me, but it's comfortable and it's clothes. My cheeks aren't out. My tits aren't out. I'm wearing something comfortable. I don't care how you feel about it. Does my makeup match the rest of my outfit? No. Does this necklace? Well, I got this necklace for $1. It's a great reflection of how I feel about this life. Is it because of climate change or society's unrealistic expectations? Probably a mixture of both. This necklace is a reflection of me. I am melting. One day there will be nothing left to melt. Do I have problems? Yes. I recognize that. I have self-awareness, but I am okay with most of what I am, because I'm not hurting people, okay? You only need to feel like shit if you are hurting people, okay? Then I would say that maybe yes, you should feel like shit about yourself. But if you're not a horrible person, you're just going through your day-in-day life, trying to make it through this miserable existence, there is really nothing to prove to anybody. So what if you tripped in the hallway and people saw you fucking trip? So what if the interaction you had with a person was awkward? If you're an awkward person, that's just how it be. I mumble a lot. Does that make me feel like shit about myself? No, I named my channel after that, so that anybody who complains about my mumbling can refer to my fucking name and say, hey, maybe she mumbles. Yes, I mumble, it's okay. If you have a lisp, there's nothing wrong with you. It's okay to have these little quirks. In fact, I think it's cooler to be different than to fit in. And you know, society doesn't like us. Society doesn't like people who stick out like a sore thumb. But to hell with it. Would you rather live for yourself, or would you rather live for somebody else? Do what you want to do, okay? And stop letting the anxiety take you over. Stop trying to fit in. That's boring. Stop trying to fit in. Stop. If it's killing you, just stop. Do what you want to do. They say that life is a gift and life is free, right? I mean, it sure as hell isn't. I'm paying to post this video on the internet, okay? Sure, YouTube says it's free. I have to pay for internet. Nothing in this life is free. The sooner you realize that, the better. No, life is not a gift, because a gift is given. I've had to pay for it. Who goes to a birthday party and gives you a gift and then says, hey, you know, I'd like $50 for that gift I just gave you? That's how life works. It's not free. It's not a gift. Before I was conceived, my parents had to pay to be alive. You have to pay to be alive. And if you're not paying, then somebody else is paying for it. Paying for the fucking groceries, the fucking shelter for you to live under. Nothing in life is free. Nothing about life is a gift. Letting personal politics come into this. Oh no, really? It's my channel. Do I have mental issues? Yes. Do I have depression? Yes. Do I care? Not really. Not really. How to be unbothered. First, look at yourself as a whole and think to myself, is there really anything wrong with me? And do those things really need to be changed? I'm not saying that you shouldn't always be working on yourself as a person. I'm not saying that you shouldn't strive to be better. I personally like to learn about new things. I always thought I hated learning because I was learning the wrong things. I was learning things that I wasn't interested in. But with things that interest me, I find I do like to learn. I really do. Just find what you like to do. Stop trying to follow everybody else. Stop trying to fit in. That's so boring. That's so lame. It'll only lead to you being miserable in the end. If you want to be happy, stop comparing. Well, okay, no, I can't say that. Because I don't compare, and I'm not happy. The fourth step to stop hating yourself is to stop comparing. I should have been number one, to be honest. Stop comparing. Who cares what Joe Schmo over here is doing with his life, okay? Focus on yourself. Joe Schmo over here is making 300K a year. Okay, good for him. We are not the same person. Okay, did I grow up in a well-off family that was able to put me through college? No, and that's why I'm not going to college. Also, do I want to go to college? No, that's why I'm not going to college. This Jane Smith over here, did she have the same opportunities and situation as me? Because we are not the same. It's hard to not compare. I didn't get this way by just saying stop comparing. Of course it took work, and of course it took curating my social media and my friend group and just, you know, people in my life in general. Cut out the people who are not serving you. I'm not saying serving you like a slave as in you don't give them anything in return. I'm talking about people who make you feel like shit for being yourself. Cut those people out. Ignore everybody else's life. Don't compare. It's none of your business, quite frankly, what other people are up to. Focus on yourself. Focus on yourself. Do you like to walk around in your pajamas? Do that. You don't need to be properly dressed all the time with a full face of makeup. Anybody who is worth my time will take me as I am. I don't have to prove myself to people. Neither do you. So stop trying to fit in. It's boring. Quite frankly, it's boring. How do you become confident, Maya? How do you put your face on the internet looking like a complete clown and not give a shit? Maybe it helps that I don't give a shit about my life. How could you laugh about this, Maya? Your life is important. To some people, my family, my boyfriend, other people who love me, no, it's not important to me. This existence is miserable. I might as well at least like myself, you know what I'm saying? Do I beat myself up for my thoughts sometimes? Yes, I do. Not all my thoughts, or should I say most of my thoughts, aren't positive. But I don't tell myself that there's something wrong with me, that my feelings aren't valid. You need to stay away from people who are invalidating your thoughts. Yes, we all need work. We all need self-awareness. I'm well aware of this. I might eternally be a mess. It doesn't mean that I'm not working on myself. It just means that I accept that. I accept that I need work. I accept that I am a mess. There's nothing wrong with that. Nobody is perfect, and acting like you are, quite frankly, is a red flag. Hint, hint, Elon Musk. That man was better off just not talking. Not opening his mouth. A lot of people are better off not opening their mouths. Maybe you think that's me. I don't care. Not caring doesn't mean not caring about other people's opinions on what they think about you. It just means when to separate actual criticism from people putting you down. People can offer you criticism and you can take it. Or you can leave it. You know, you don't have to do anything that anybody is telling you to do. If a troll comes onto your page and just says you're ugly, fuck them. You don't need to listen to them. Who cares what that miserable troll thinks? Who cares? If somebody thinks that you're not funny, okay, go find somebody who you think is funny then. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. It's a different story if somebody's trying to tell you you're a horrible person because such and such. The best way to also feel good about yourself is to do research. Know thyself. Know what you believe in. If people think you're a horrible person for embracing antinatalism, dive deeper into antinatalism. The best way you can confirm your doubts is to do research. Read. Dive into certain philosophies. Dive into what you believe in. Confirm those beliefs. It's better for you to believe something that you solely believe in than to believe in something that somebody else is telling you to believe in. Because then you can actually have a conversation. And conversations are important. important. As I often say, we don't get anywhere if we don't talk to people. We don't change anybody's mind if we don't talk to people. Yes, it's not my job to educate you. I'm not trying to add to the trend of I have no friends. I do have friends. I just don't have friends that I see often. I don't really care. I mean, it doesn't help that I see most people as NPCs, because complacency will do that to you. But there's nothing I can do about it at the end of the day. If I see something that's really problematic, I try to start a conversation. But if not, you know, if nobody's hurting anybody, I just move on with my life. It doesn't really matter what other people are doing with their lives to me, as long as they're not hurting people.
What was that step?
I don't know. We are rambling, as we often do in this channel. We will always be works in progress. Your issue with life might be that you don't have enough self-love, self-confidence, enough reason to see yourself as worthy. And quite frankly, you should. Don't beat yourself up about life. Don't take it so seriously. Nothing about this existence makes sense. That sure as hell doesn't to me. Whatever reason you have for justifying your existence, whether that be God, whether that be your job, whether that you be, I don't know, a thirst for money. I mean, I don't understand it, but whatever reason you might have, what does life mean to you? What is important to you? That's all that's important. Whatever is important to you. Don't compare, don't bother with the trivialities of this world, these trivial, unnecessary worries. I mean, again, if people make you feel like shit, you probably just need a better friend group, or you need to hang out with better people. Because there are a lot of shitty people in this world, and you just might be hanging out with some of them. If people around you are constantly changing themselves and getting body modifications, and they can't even go out without a wig, and then maybe you're hanging out with insecure people, which is gonna make you feel insecure. So hang out with people that you aspire to be like. And I'm not saying hang out with people, get plastic surgery all the time, as I don't know if that's any aspiration to have in life, to be constantly changing your perfectly healthy natural body. I don't care what anybody says. Nobody outside of health issues needs plastic surgery. I will always look at it weird. It's your choice. And that choice should always be available, because yes, how are we to be free as human beings if we don't have a choice in the matter? But I don't think people need it. And there's nothing wrong with you. You have curls on your head? Great. You are a curly girl. Welcome to the team. There are plenty of us out here who have curls. Your hair is straight. It's wavy. Your hair is thin. That's just how it is. Join a community of people who have the same quote-unquote problems. They're not problems, but society makes them feel / look like problems. They're not problems. Just be kinder to yourself. Be nicer to yourself. Stop being so hard on yourself. There's no need to go through life constantly beating yourself up over every little thing. It doesn't matter in the grand scheme of things. At the end of the day, you're gonna die. So, do you want to spend, I don't know, 50 plus years of your life not liking you? Or do you want to spend 50 plus years of your life focusing on changing other things that matter, like this stupid fucking society, or the fact that money is inaccessible to a lot of people, the cost of living, just basic necessities? Like, before you start focusing on how you look and blah blah blah, you need to get your basic necessities in order. Make sure you're eating well, eating good, healthy, nutritious food, exercising regularly, even if that means just going out on a walk every now and then. Nobody's telling you to go to the gym. You don't have to go and break your back doing push-ups every day. You don't have to do shit that you don't want to do, because that's not sustainable. At the end of the day, if exercising is miserable to you, you're not going to want to do it. So just incorporate into your daily life. Walk to the grocery store sometimes, or just walk around your neighborhood with your pet. I don't know, I guess you can put a cat on a leash. I don't know. Don't be so hard on yourself. It's okay to be you. It's okay to be different. It's okay to stick out like a sore thumb. It's okay to have foam in your armpits from your freaking deodorant. It's okay to put on goth makeup but then wear colors, a mismatched outfit. It's okay to have your stomach out. Do what you want. People argue we're free. We're not free. But you might as well pretend we are. Fuck the status quo. Fuck them telling us to dress a certain way. Fuck them telling us to live our lives a certain way. Be beautiful. You are Kenuff. We are all Kenuff. I am Kenuff. If y'all watched the Barbie movie, let me know how you felt about it in the comments. I think that's about it, because I have to get back to work.
Get back to fucking work. It's time to get back to work.
Because I'm still technically on the clock. Oh my god! Nice life you're living, huh, Maya? Yeah. Yeah. I only feel nice about my life when I'm not working. If you would like me to come back with some more tips, let me know in the comments. If you hated this video, let me know in the comments. If you missed me, let me know in the comments. And if you want me to get back to the Reddit shit, let me know in the comments, because I don't know. I'll do a video on anything at this point. Like, It doesn't really matter. I'll ramble. It's my editing, okay? I'll turn it into something. I'll always turn it into some sort of masterpiece.
Wow.
It can be as boring as watching me lie on the floor, and I can still edit it into something entertaining. So I'll talk about anything. I know people look at me and be like, you're not the best example of this, Maya. Okay, you're not fat. You have an ass. People want to be like you, Maya. Maybe. Perhaps. I don't know. Am I grateful to be in the shape I am? Yes. But I wasn't always. I used to have an eating disorder. I literally would eat the least amount of calories I could throughout the day so that I could finally obtain a thigh gap, which was trending at the time of my eating disorder. And honestly, what spiraled me into an eating disorder in the first place? No, even skinny people don't like themselves at some point or another. It just comes down to seeing yourself and taking yourself as how you are. Nothing wrong with liking yourself. You are deserving of love, whatever shape, form you are in. Whether you're obese, whether you're anorexic, in between, fit, going to the gym, you are deserving of love. That doesn't change. You're human. You're deserving of love, whether you like your body or not. Start with self-care. That's the best way to get there. Start with self-care. Take care of yourself. Eat good, nutritious meals. Don't live off of pizza and deep fried foods. Not because they will make you fat, but because they're just simply not nutritionally beneficial. I'm not saying to cut it out. I'm just saying eat to make yourself feel good. I'm not even a salad person. I don't care for salads, but I like cucumbers. I like salsa. I like kale, greens. You don't have to eat food you don't want to eat. Just learn about some nutrition. I assure you, as soon as you start eating better and just exercising regularly, you will already feel better about yourself. It's just scientifically proven to make you feel better, brain-wise, which will then affect the rest of you. It's a mentality at the end of the day. It's okay to like yourself. There's nothing wrong with being you. I don't know who needed to hear this today, but it's okay to be you. There's nothing wrong with being you. I hope that this was a little more reaffirming. Your thoughts are valid. Everything about you, you are valid. You are a human being. You are deserving of love. Whatever shape, size, or form you come in, however your viewpoint of the world is, okay, as long as you ain't out here trying to kill people, there's nothing wrong with you. Take that as you will. Focus on self-care, self-love, and anything else that makes you feel like shit about yourself needs to go. Get it out of here. It doesn't need to be here. You don't need to be feeling miserable about yourself. Oh, and another thing. Clothes, they are here to fit you, okay? You are not here to fit into the clothes. You were not made to fit into the clothes. The clothes were made to be worn by human beings. Find clothes that you feel good and comfortable in. Even if it's not some Dior, who knows, luxury branded shit. Find something that you feel comfortable in, that makes you feel confident. Because maybe your wardrobe also just sucks. I don't know, maybe you're wearing horribly baggy clothes, which I do too. Where would you like? Where would you like? Thank you for watching this unscripted, messy video that I decided to come back with after my weeks of inactivity. Apologize if this video was shorter than you expected. We might get into shorter videos, I don't know. That might make me more consistent, because when I have an hour video to edit, it's a lot of work. Much love to you all, even to you haters, which I am, I'm a hater. Subscribe if you'd like to see more of me, or don't. It's okay. Have a nice life.